Okay, let's get started. Good morning, all of you. Any questions from last class? So if there are no questions, let's get started.
Good morning to all of you.
Last class, this is where we left. Please note that whatever design loads you are going to use are the loads that you are going to use for estimating the moments that are coming on the flexural member. Those loads should be design loads. And those design loads, how to calculate those design loads, they are given, related information is given here. Design load is given by, this is the design load, this characteristic load or service load. Characteristic load, last class I explained to you, whenever you see this word characteristic appended to either material properties or loads, then the definition is going to be similar. That is, the term characteristic load means that the value of load which has 95% probability of not being exceeded during the life of the structure. Okay, so that is what is characteristic load. And IS 875 part 1 and part 2, they are giving load related information. Okay, dead load and self weight, for calculating self weight, dead loads and also live loads. If you want, I will show you that. IS 875 part 1. Read this title here. Code of practice for design loads other than earthquake for buildings and structures. And what are the loads, the design loads that are given here? Dead loads, unit weights of building materials and stored materials. Based on this, you can, depending on the type of material that you are adopting for your construction, or let's say your flexural member, to get the self weight of it, you can make use of the unit weights that are given here. If some of the unit weights of some let's say new materials are missing, then you can take the look at the manufacturer's certificate, okay? Or determine using standard procedure what is the unit weight of that material. So for commonly used materials, IS 875 part 1 is giving you dead loads for various kinds of building materials and stored materials. So using this, you can calculate, or whatever loads that are given here, they are all characteristic loads. Okay, and similarly part 2, what is the title? Code of practice for design loads other than earthquake for buildings and structures. Title remains same. Part 2 deals with imposed loads. Okay, what should be the live load, or what should be the load that I need to use when I'm designing a residential building? And if I want to design a function hall, or if I want to design a hospital, or if I want to design, let's say, a parliament building or assembly or classroom, what loads I need to consider, they are given here. And even in a house, different locations, what should be the load that needs to be considered for living room or kitchen, some of the details are given here, okay? So using this, these loads are characteristic loads. What IS 456, is saying is, you need to calculate design load. Once you have that value, you multiply with a partial safety factor appropriate to the nature of loading and the limit state being considered. So we need to keep in mind what is the nature of loading, means what type of load is this, and also what limit state we are considering. Okay, so if you go down table 18, let me zoom in little bit so that it will fit in the page. So values of partial safety factor for loads, and there we read that it depends on the type of load, different loads, dead load, imposed load, wind load. And also it depends on the type of the limit state that you are considering. Limit state of collapse, limit state of serviceability. Limit state of collapse, limit state of serviceability. Limit states of serviceability, you already looked at two limit states of serviceability. One is deflection, another is crack width. For those kinds of limit states, these are the loads that you need to consider. Or these are the partial safety factor that you need to consider associated with those loads. Okay, just a reminder, this assignment for due date is today, and very few people have submitted. Please submit your assignment to my S mail. Okay, don't send to WhatsApp or this and that. Okay, because I will not be able to download you all your WhatsApp messages. Anyway, that is on side note. Okay. So now partial safety factor for loads is going to depend on the type of load, dead load, imposed load, wind load, or even earthquake load here. While considering earthquake effects, substitute EL for WL. So wherever wind load is there, you replace with R. In its place, you take it as earthquake load. Okay. So these are the, this table gives you an idea about what should be the partial safety factor that we need to consider. Okay, so now this is just a information. Anyway, we'll come back to this once we are going through some examples in today's class. Okay, any questions? So this is where we stopped last class. Okay, once you know the moment carrying capacity, or moment of resistance of an under reinforced section is going to be dictated by the amount of steel, and from that we are getting this relation. And assuming you know what is your design moment or factored moment. Factored moment is nothing but whatever service moment multiplied by or moment that is calculated using factored loads or design loads. That is what is this design moment or factored moment. So once you have this design moment or target moment to which you need to design a flexural member, you can make use of this equation and try to calculate what is the area of steel. And all this we have gone through this. Okay. I don't want to repeat and again and again go through this. All this is given in Annex G, okay, to get the neutral axis depth. And also, once you get neutral axis depth, you know, or we already noted how to calculate the lever arm distance. And if the tensile force or steel is going to dictate the moment of resistance, this is the equation we get. And here, XU, you substitute this quantity, then you are going to get a quadratic equation in area of steel, AST. Solve that quadratic equation to get the area of steel. And that is what we discussed in the last class. We went through all this and I also asked you to note down this percentage of steel. Okay? PT. PT is defined here. PT is nothing but AST divided by BD. Or if you want directly area of steel, you can actually get that as well. So I also ask you to make a note of this equation. If you have not done it, if you have not noted these equations, first I suggest you note down these two equations, PT and AST, because in today's class also we'll be using. And also if you have any questions, you can raise at this stage. Professor Amlan, you want to add something? And after these equations, what we did in the last class is we looked at SP16 and tried to understand how to read the table 1 to 4 and charts 1 to 18. Professor Amlan.
So you can go ahead now. I will speak later.
So please take a note of these two equations. This is just if you want, you don't need to mug up this equation. You can directly, you are going to get a quadratic equation in area of steel. And if you take realistic root and put it in a proper form, This is how it's going to look like. Okay. And if you want, you can write it this in a shortcut form by defining some other intermediate quantity. This RU is in this particular source from where I have taken the, this material. In that, this is compact. This equation is compactly written like this by defining intermediate quantity. So you please also take a note of this. Also, I sent this assignment 5. Assignment 5 is nothing but whatever the questions that you solved in assignment 2 and 3 put together, you try to solve using the same set of problems using limit state method. Whatever you have done earlier is working stress method. I want you to repeat with limit state method. Okay. So the example or the problems comprises of under reinforced and over reinforced. Please note that in limit state, over reinforced is not recommended to be used. If you happen to encounter a over reinforced kind of section, you need to redesign it. So that you need to keep in mind. And so you need to repeat the same questions, okay, including the flanged sections, everything. So let's go and proceed further. So PT is given by this, ASP is given by this one. And also please note that here the limiting or moment of resistance of the section is expressed in terms of the tensile region or in terms of area of steel. Or if you want, you can even do it in terms of this compressive region. Okay, 0.362 multiplied by FCK multiplied by the neutral axis depth of this section multiplied by the lever arm distance. You please take a note of this equation. We will be making use of this, okay, in the subsequent slides or even in our code book, even in our SP16, these equations are used to get the tables that are actually given there. So please take a note of this equation. And this QU, what is Q? Q is nothing but this factor which is connecting moment with the section dimensions. Okay? Resisting moment factor. So Q is given by this. And if you want Q, we have seen in the previous slide some quantity, intermediate quantity, you can express in terms of that. That is what is given here. Okay, you please take a note of these equations, because once we start looking at some of the worked out examples, we'll make use of these equations. Okay. I'm proceeding further. So here, moment of resistance of the section is calculated with respect to the concrete. And once you get this, let's say you are taking this path, that is calculating moment of resistance using the compression region, taking compression region into account or with respect to concrete. Once you get this, you can also estimate the area of steel. Our area of steel can be estimated using this relation. I'm just showing you all these relations because once we start looking at some problems, we'll be making use of these equations. And similarly, lever arm distance or lever arm coefficient, lever arm factor, J is expressed in terms of that intermediate quantity RU, okay? Okay, so far what we looked at is under reinforced section. It's an under reinforced section. neutral axis depth is found by equating the total compression to total tension. And what is the limiting or the maximum XU max? How do we get XU max? How do we get XU max? XU max is nothing but for the balance section. Okay, so let's see that. For a balance section, the relation, the limiting moment of resistance, or you can also write it as MU max. MU max is given by Q, this equation, Q BD square. Okay, actually here there is a mistake here, Q times QU times FCK. It should be QU times FCK, or here in Q FCK is defined. So anyway, this is correct only, okay? This is correct. But if this FCK, while defining this Q, QU, FCK is not included here, that then FCK has to be included here. Okay, so same equation for a balanced section, it is written here. And QU max is defined like this. QU max is defined like this. Please take a note of this equation. And how do you get QU max? Wherever XU by D is there, you replace it with XU max divided by D or XU limit divided by D. How do you get XU max divided by D or XU limit divided by D? It is given in IS 456 for different grades of steel. Because this XU max divided by D is going to be a function of only the yield stress in steel. And there is a relation relating this XU max divided by D with FY, which we obtained from properties of similar triangles. Of strain distribution diagram. Okay, just a minute. Let me go and show you that for completeness. So this is that equation. This is what I'm talking about. Okay. So let's come back to this one. For balance section, MU limit is given by MU max. Our MU limit is same as MU max, and that is given by QU max FCK BD square. And how QU max is defined? MU limit divided by BD square. MU limit divided by BD square. Please take a note of this equation. Now, what is this Q? Q is nothing but resisting moment factor. So Q for a balanced section in limit state is going to depend on, it's going to depend on the grade of concrete. It's going to depend on grade of concrete, and in a way it's going to depend on grade of steel, because XU limit is going to depend on the grade of steel, FY. So please take a note of this equation. So once you have this equation, that is that this QU max value is written for different grades of steel. Different grades of steel, it is written in terms of different grades of concrete, FCK. So if you are using mild steel, FE250, then MU limit is given by this equation. Please take a note of this. All this information is given in your SP16. I will show you where it is given. For mild steel, MU limit is this. For FE415 steel, MU limit is given by this one. FE500, MU limit is given by this one. Okay? So where this is given in SP16? Here. SP16 table C is giving you that. Just now we noted MU limit divided by FCK BD square. This is for a balanced section. And we have that the factors are there here. 0.1498, and round it up to the nearest significant digit, like a 3 digits or something, then you get whatever is given here. For different types of steels, Fe250, Fe415, Fe5M. And also this PT limit, PT percentage of steel, tensile steel, the limiting value for a balanced section, that we have already noted earlier. That we have already noted earlier here, this quantity. That is given, this equation for different grades of steel, and it is this FCK is taken, this is rearranged, Fy times PT limit divided by FCK. That is what is given in directly in SP16. PT limit multiplied by Fy divided by FCK is going to be function of XU max. It's going to be a function of XU max divided by D. So that is what is given in table C of SP16 in the here. Okay. Anyway, once you solve some examples, then you will get a feel for it. You will get a feel for it once you solve some examples, because then once you make use of this. So whatever we discuss, it is summarized in this table. Okay. So we discussed about balance section, and just earlier to this we discussed under reinforced section. What is left? Over reinforced. Before that, once you get, please note that we try to, when we are designing a section, once the loads are known, once the span of the beam is known and boundary conditions are known, we need to, when we are designing, basically it involves prescribing the section dimensions as well as area of steel, similar to what we did for working stress method. When we are designing, we try to target it to be like a balanced section. A balanced section is the one where here this strain ultimate or the extreme fiber strain in compression in concrete, according to limit state, it is going to be limited to 0.2035. So the limiting strain value in the extreme fiber in concrete reaching 0.2035, simultaneously steel reaching its limiting value, which is 0.87 Fy divided by Es plus 0.202. Okay, strain in steel, in tensile steel, shall not be less than that value. So the limiting value is 0.87 Fy divided by Es plus 0.202. So a section which this happens simultaneously, both the strains in steel and concrete reaches their these limiting values, that's a balanced section. Okay, for such kind of section, we try to aim to design for such kind of section. So once you have this target moment or design moment, you can make use of the equation mu is equal to qu bd square, similar to working stress method, but only thing is qu is different here. And whatever D you get, you need to round it off to the higher side. So that is what it is written here. In proportioning a singly reinforced rectangular section, the dimensions can be obtained using this relation. D shall be greater than or equal to square root of mu divided by qu multiplied by B. If this is greater than or equal to, then Q is going to be less than that for a balanced section. Anyway, you will experience this once you solve some examples, okay? And the difference between QU and QU max will indicate the magnitude of under reinforcement. Okay, so this is about balance section, under reinforced section. What about over reinforced section? You need to keep this in mind, and also in annexergy, it's clearly mentioned, annexergy of IS 456, where XU is greater than XU max, or MU is greater than MU limit, the section is over reinforced, and the over reinforced section is not permitted. It should be redesigned. Okay? So let's take some examples. Let's go through those. Any questions here? So let's take some examples. And before that, as we did for working stress method, we'll do some analysis as well as design. Analysis in the sense, given a section, how to find its limiting moment of resistance and load carrying capacity, all those things. And if it is a design problem, finding the section dimensions and area of steel for a singly reinforced section. So what are the steps in the analysis? Here, let's go through this. Analysis of rectangular beams. In this type of problems, the dimensions of the beam section B and D, area of steel, grades or characteristic strength values of materials, FCK, FY, are given. And the following types of problems are generally encountered in the analysis of concrete beams reinforced in tension only. So we'll see two types of these problems, okay? First type of problem is determining the limiting or ultimate moment carrying capacity of beam section. Once other information is given. So what we need, how to proceed? Find the position of actual neutral axis, XU. You're making use of the equation that is given in annexergy of IS 456. And if you see that equation, XU is going to depend on B, D, A, AST, FCK, FY. So find the position of actual neutral axis, XU. And you know the grade of steel, FY is known. So you can easily find what is the limiting value of neutral axis depth for that particular type of steel. Find position of critical neutral axis, XU max. The XU max divided by D values are already given. So you look at that XU max divided by D, and here the section dimensions are given. So you already know what is D, so you can calculate what is XU max. So now you got the actual neutral axis depth. You also got what is XU max, which you can call it as critical neutral axis depth. So you know critical neutral axis depth and actual neutral axis depth. You compare XU with XU max, compare XU with XU max. And if XU is less than XU max, then it is under reinforced. If XU is greater than XU max, that is over reinforced. And calculate the moment carrying capacity for the appropriate type of beam section. For over reinforced section, please note that we are actually looking at analysis. So we are not designing. We are doing analysis, given a section, dimensions as well as area of steel, estimating its moment carrying capacity. So If the section turns out, or if your XU turns out to be greater than XU max, then that kind of section can be classified as over reinforced. For over reinforced section, concrete is going to reach its limiting value first, so compression region is going to govern. Here we are analyzing. Okay, we are analyzing the section. If it is designed, if this happens in design, then we need to redesign it as under reinforced. Okay, here MU limit for this kind of over reinforced section, compression region, so total compressive force 0.362 FCK XU. Instead of XU, you take the limiting value. Limiting value, because here we need to limit it to whatever this critical value, because here we are estimating for a section which is over reinforced. So we cannot use the actual neutral axis depth. We need to use the limiting neutral axis depth. So look at this formula carefully. If it turns out to be over reinforced, you limit its capacity to its taking neutral axis depth as for a balanced section. So 0.362 FCK XU max multiplied by B multiplied by Leverum. Leverum is D minus 0.416 XU. Instead of XU, you need to take it as XU max for over reinforced. And if it is under reinforced, steel is going to govern your moment carrying capacity. So limiting moment carrying capacity is given by this formula. 0.87 Fy times Leverum D minus 0.416 XU. Okay, is it clear these two types of problems? So if it is clear, so let's take some numerical example. Actually, I have shown you this this example. We looked at it in the last class, but the workout is not shown. So in today's class, I want to show you that. Take a note of this problem. Determine limiting moment carrying capacity of reinforced concrete rectangular section of size 250 by 550. 550 is effective depth, reinforced on tension side with 4 bars of 20 mm diameters. Okay? Grade of concrete is M20, reinforcing steel is Fe250. Take a note of this. So Fe250, for Fe250, what is XU max divided by D? Quickly, somebody tell me that. For Fe250, what is XU max divided by D? Which is given in page 70 of IS 456. You need to respond, okay? Nobody is responding.
0.53.
Huh?
0.53.
What is that?
0.53.
Okay, 0.53, that is only 2 significant digits, and in this slide, even up to 4 significant digits, that value is given. Or you can even refer SP16, okay, for getting that XU max divided by D. Once you get XU max divided by D, here the actual effective depth is given for this section. So you get XU max, so that is the critical neutral axis depth. And actual neutral axis depth, you can calculate actual neutral axis depth based on whatever information is given. B is 250, D is 550 mm, and area of steel is 4 bars of 20 mm diameters. Okay, 4 bars of 20 mm diameter. So based on that, you can find area of steel. FCK is 20 Newton per mm square. Fy is 250. 250 Newton per mm square. Okay, so using all this equation given in annexure G of IS 456, or you can directly equate total compressive force to total tensile force and get actual neutral axis depth. Compare actual neutral axis depth with critical neutral axis depth. Find whether the section is under reinforced or over reinforced, all that, whatever we looked at. So all that is what is done here. All that is what is carried out. You see the workout here. B is noted, D is noted, area of steel, FCK, FY, equating compressive force to the tensile force, XU, actual neutral axis depth is calculated, and the maximum permitted. Maximum permitted is nothing but for this section dimensions. For this section dimensions, And for this grade of steel, what is the limiting critical neutral axis depth? That is given by this one. So you need to compare actual neutral axis depth with critical neutral axis depth. Here, actual neutral axis depth turns out to be less than critical neutral axis depth. So steel is going to dictate your moment carrying capacity. So it is calculated, okay? Or here, actual neutral axis depth is less than critical neutral axis depth. So the section is under reinforced, okay? It's straightforward. It's very simple problem for illustration purpose. Any questions here? Any questions? So if not, let's proceed further. I don't know whether you are taking note of this or not. Okay. Be alert and try to note down whatever is required. Professor Amlan, you want to add something? Okay, let's proceed further. Let's take this example. Reinforced concrete rectangular section, size 300 by 600 mm effective, reinforced with 3 bars of 20 mm diameter, determine safe uniformly distributed load that the beam can carry over a simply supported effective span of 6 meters. Concrete mix and steel used are M28 Fe415. For the given environmental exposure, effective cover to the reinforcement is 50 mm. Here, what is asked? Determine the safe uniformly distributed load. Determine the safe uniformly distributed load. Assuming the beam to be simply supported, span is 6 meters. Okay, so that you need to keep in mind. So whatever uniformly distributed load, that multiplied by L square divided by 8 is going to be the moment that is coming on the beam. That you need to keep in mind. Here effective depth as well as cover is given. This information is to estimate the self weight of the beam. Okay, so let's take a note of all this. B is 300, small d is 600, so overall depth is 650 mm. FCK is given, FY is given, area of steel 3 bars of 20 mm diameter. Take a note of it. So as usual, here the section dimensions are given, material properties are given. So you find limiting neutral axis depth or critical neutral axis depth, as well as the actual neutral axis depth, and compare, and then check whether it is going to be under reinforced or over reinforced. And once you decide on that, you estimate its limiting moment carrying capacity. Once you get limiting moment carrying capacity, please note that whatever limiting moment carrying capacity that you get is going to be for the factored load. Factored load includes dead load as well as imposed loads. We estimate the self weight of the beam, assuming some value for density of concrete. And from that, once you get the self weight or the dead load, you find the design value of that dead load by multiplying 1.5. And then from the total load you get, you need to subtract that. And then whatever is left out, that is going to be your design imposed load. And if you want actual design load or service, actual imposed load or service load, that load has to be divided with 1.5. So all that details are given here. First you calculate axial neutral axis depth and limiting neutral axis depth or critical neutral axis depth for this grade of concrete and the section dimensions that are given, and check whether the section is under reinforced or over reinforced. Here it is, turns out to be under reinforced. Okay, and this is the limiting moment of resistance. If this is limiting moment of resistance, we can estimate the load, assuming to be simply supported, assuming beam to be simply supported over a span of 6 meters, because that information is given in the problem statement, and get the factored load. So that is what is written here. Let WD is the factored design load in kilonewton per meter. The factored moment is given by WD L squared divided by 8. L is 6 meters. Okay? So this is the design moment, factored moment or design moment. And this we need to equate it to the limiting moment and try to find what is this design load. Once you get the design load, you can divide with partial safety factor for. Please note here, before we proceed, here in IS 456, what is the, for dead load and imposed load combination, what is the factor, partial safety factor for dead load? It is 1.5, as well as imposed loads also, it is 1.5. So for both dead load and imposed load, it is 1.5. So that is the reason this design load, WD is divided with 1.5 to get the service load. And in this service load, self weight has to be accounted as well as imposed load. So self weight of the beam is calculated. Section dimensions are 300 mm by 650 mm overall depth. Unit meter length, density of concrete, 25 kilonewton per meter cube. So self weight is estimated. And from this load, you subtract the self weight, you get this safe imposed. That is the load you can, service load that you can apply on the beam, taking partial safety factors and all those things into account. Any questions here? So this is an analysis problem, okay?
See, I had mentioned earlier during the working stress method that this type of analysis problems in practice can occur for existing buildings. That if you want to change the use of a building, then you need to first check what's its capacity, either under service condition or in the limiting case, and then try to back calculate whatever load it can carry and compare that with the new demand for the new usage. Okay.
So we have a few minutes left. Let's see now, that is the part of analysis, okay? And now let's see a design problem of a singly reinforced section. Design, we can split it or we can look at two types of problems. Determination of tensile steel alone, okay? In this type of problems, cross-sectional dimensions are fixed from architectural or other considerations. So cross-sectional dimensions are fixed. And the materials to be used and design moment to be carried or not. And what are the steps? Materials are fixed. Once materials are fixed, you can find what is PT limit and QU max from SP16 or whatever formulas you have already noted. PT limit is going to be a function of FCK, FY, okay? And the section dimensions. Let me show you that. That's why I'm saying you need to make a note of those equations, okay? So here, PT limit is going to be a function of FCK, FY, XU max divided by D. So we have a section where the section dimensions are already fixed and also type of materials are also fixed. So now, as a part of design, we are asked to find what is the amount of steel that needs to be used for that, for desisting that moment. So PT limit, once the section dimensions are known and once the material properties are known, you can find this PT limit. And also similarly, QU max. QU max is going to be a function of only this material properties. Here XU limit is there. XU limit is function of FY and FCK and also the section properties D. So find these two quantities. So compute the design constants for the materials. Okay, and also determine the limiting moment carrying capacity of the section. Limiting moment carrying capacity, because section dimensions are fixed here. Section dimensions are fixed and also the material properties are fixed. So you can calculate limiting moment carrying capacity of the section. Why? What is this limiting moment carrying capacity? It is corresponding to a balanced section. Because over-reinforced section is not, because please note that we are looking at design. Over-reinforced section is not permitted. So this is the limiting capacity of the section corresponding to the balanced section, corresponding to the capacity of a balanced section for this section dimensions as well as for this grade of steel. This is the limiting moment capacity of the section. So you need to calculate this. And compute the reinforcement for this limiting moment of limiting moment capacity. Is this clear? Because the dimensions are fixed from architectural and other considerations, and also material properties are fixed, and we are asked to find area of steel. We adopt this kind of approach. So an example is given here. An example is given, you can go through it. Find the limiting moment carrying capacity of a reinforced concrete rectangular section, 200 by 425 effective depth, area of mild steel required. Limiting moment carrying capacity as well as mild steel information is given, and area of steel, mild steel that is required. Concrete is of M20 grade. So take a note of all that information, and once the grade of steel is fixed, you can find what is neutral axis, limiting neutral axis depth or critical neutral axis depth. And also you can find limiting moment carrying capacity of the section. Okay, and also once you get limiting moment capacity of the section, using this one, using this value, we need to provide steel to actually resist this much moment. So you divide this, area of steel is obtained by equating 0.87 Fy times area of steel equal to this quantity. So you back calculate what is the area of steel. That information is missing. The area of steel can be calculated from here. Okay. You please work it out. You divide this value with 0.87 times 250 Newton per mm square. But you need to use consistent units. Okay. and get the area of scale. Or you can also, making use of this information, you can also adopt a different approach. You can actually directly go and see what is the limiting moment capacity for this section. We already noted in a table, and this is also given in your SP16. This value is also given in your SP16 here. Limiting moment capacity. Here, limiting moment of resistance is given by this. Your grade of concrete steel is known, mild steel, and FCK is 20 Newton per mm square. B and D are fixed, so you can find what is limiting moment of resistance using this one. So this is what is written here. Limiting moment of resistance can be, only thing is here it is four significant digits are taken. So limiting moment of resistance is uptime. And also, what is the steel that needs to be provided? That also you can find it from here. Limiting tensile steel. What is the limiting moment of resistance and reinforcement index? It's mentioned reinforcement index because it is normalized. If you want just PT limit, percentage of tensile steel, limiting value, Fy is known, FCK is known. For mild steel, the constant is 21.97. You can calculate what is PT limit. That is percentage of steel. PT is nothing but 100 times AST divided by BD. So you can back calculate what is the area of steel. Our area of steel also can be calculated using the critical neutral axis depth. That is another way of doing it. So different ways it is shown here in the same example. Different ways of calculating the area of steel is shown in the same example. Okay. Any questions? I think today you are not active. Understand, you need to be active. So anyway, we'll cover rest of the examples. We'll cover in next class, as well as doubly reinforced section. And then meanwhile, what I suggest is you start looking at whoever have completed, already completed assignment 4. You start working on assignment 5, which is nothing but repeating assignment 2 and 3 problems using limit state method. So with whatever we covered today, you should be able to solve some of the problems. Any questions?
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, half an hour ago, we got mail from Dean Academic Courses, sir. And it's stating that the assignment deadlines and whatever the academic activities, it must be like a few days after the 5th October, sir.
No, that is for, you please note that this thing is started, M-Tech level courses, B-Tech level courses, okay? Please note that is a guideline, okay? But if you are comfortable in submitting your assignments, instead of piling up your assignments, don't try to use that one and try to delay your submissions. There is no harm in submitting. No? Whoever is completing, they are submitting. Okay?
It's since latest assignment is comprising of the assignment 2 and 3, it's like a too lengthy, sir. That's why we are asking to extend.
What is the deadline I have given you? It's 9th October. Okay, 2 weeks time is there. Anyway, you see that, okay? We'll see. It's not that the objective of these assignments is to make sure that you are learning something. It's not you're putting some, it's not 100 meters running race or something like that. Okay?
Okay.
Mr. Amlan, you want to add something?
No, not right now.
Okay, thank you very much. Let's meet tomorrow.